はい。目を開けてカップの中身を改めてください。
さてさて、そなたが初めて使う魔法はいかほどのものか。
Taking her time and dragging out the suspense a little, the older sister lifted up the cup.
Oh, yeah?
And nothing. When the cup was lifted up, there lay a single golden rose petal.
これは魔法になるでしょうか?
なるとも。そなたが魔法にて伏せたカップの中に黄金の花びらを生み出した。見事な魔法であったぞ。
愛がなければ見えない。
Oh, hello, Angie. How are you doing?
それは理解できてるの。
これを手品だと断じるもよし、魔法だと信じるもよし、そのものの独ソ次第であろうな。
でもこれはかつての魔法の一部を説明はできるけど、すべてを説明することはできないわ。話を戻すけれど、この程度の魔法やおまじないを信じるという程度の話では、かたくなに恋ができないと嘆いていた家具たちに、それを許すことのできる黄金蝶のブローチとは一体何かという問いに答えられない。
そこにいる二人のベアとの話を鵜呑みにするなら、魔法には彼らの諦めを取り除く力があると考えるのが妥当であろう。
どうして家具は恋をしてはいけないの？どうして魔法のブローチの力が必要なの？
There are a lot of questions that need to be answered.
確かに、あんたやベアトたちの話は一見、それにおぼろげとはいえ、答えを与えているような気がする。でも、朗読者だから言わせて、それでは納得がいかないの。
納得とは。
家具たちはもっともっと悲壮な宿命に抗おうとしているわ。恋愛成就のお守りを託されたくらいで、自己改革ができる程度のものだったとは思えないの。現にシャノンはかつてジョージお兄ちゃんとの出会いのきっかけを作ったのはブローチのおかげだけど、それ以降は魔法の力を借りずに関係を深めたいと言ってベアトにブローチを返そうとさえしたわ。彼女はその時点で一度は魔法の奇跡と決別したはず。なのになぜ再びその力を必要としているの？
Because it was acting like a crutch, in a way. Because it, you know, it backed up what she felt that she needed at the time. That she felt that it, when, no matter what she'd do, it would be a failure. And that she wouldn't be able to succeed without having something there to, you know, reassure her that, hey, it's gonna work out. At least how, that's how I'm getting it.
さて、恋と結婚は別物としか言いようがないであろうな。
Featherine laughed lightly. She'd probably formed a theory of her own and was laughing at Angie, who hadn't reached it yet. That's a... Fuck you two.
聞かせてよ、あんたの見解。
もう少し寝かせたい。それに疑問を持ち思考を巡らすそなたを見ることもまた朗読の楽しみだ。私の見解を話せばそなたはそれに納得し思考を止める。 それでは朗読が面白くない。すでに答えを知ってる推理小説を読ませて、右往左往するところを見て楽しんでるってわけね。それが感激の魔女というものだ。悪趣味と笑いたくば笑うがよい、我が巫女よ。
わはは は,
は。Oh my god. Just that. Oh my god, that fucking laugh. I understand that a part of magic is created by believing, by a believing heart. And that magic probably permeates deep into the world of humans as well. However, though it does permeate so far, the power that dwells within magic is small. Visiting a shrine to pray for success on a test is something that many people do. However, not many people actually credit that visit as the reason for their success. Praying like this contains no power except as a calming influence. In love, where even a small chance and a little bit of courage can cause a major change. This power might cause a massive upheaval. However, would this insurmountable fate that the furniture claimed to be in the middle of really change because of something like that? I think that in the past, the magical power of the brooch as it joined Shannon and George was a little more than a good luck charm. However, at this point, the magical power that the furniture are seeking from the brooch, it's not that something as vague as a charm. It feels much stronger, like a whole different interpretation of magic. If you believe in a sleight of hand, it becomes magic. But that's no more than a child's trick, and that only explains one part of magic. They are hoping for something. They're hoping for something with much, much more power. For true magic, not a sleight of hand.
Beatriceが霊鏡を割るのと引き換えにシャノンに与えた恋を成就させる魔法のお守り、これがそれです。
From this pocket, Cannon pulled a single wing from a gold butterfly. Though it was a single wing, it was easy to tell from its shape that it had originally been part of something with a butterfly motif.
このブローチの魔法は、シャノンにジョージ様と恋仲になる機会を与えました。しかし、それを最後まで成就する前に、僕に譲りました。だから僕はこのブローチの力で、お嬢様の好意を得ました。
そんなわけないよ。私がカノン君を好きになったのは自分の素直な気持ちだぜ。
ありがとうございます。お嬢様は人間だから魔女も魔法も信じない。無理もないことです。しかし魔法で生み出された家具の僕がここに存在すること自体が魔法の奇跡の存在する証拠なのです。
ごめん、何の話？
Jessica sort of grasped the gist of what Cannon was trying to say. However, she couldn't understand it, and it had to ask him to repeat it with a bitter smile.
僕もシャノンも恋を成就させるには魔法が必要なのです。そのための鍵がこのブローチ。僕が踏んで割ったので、僕たちは一つずつ持ち合っています。
The brooch had lost its power when it was split in half. However, if it was ever joined together again, its magic would be revived. It would revive the miraculous power that could join furniture in furniture and a human together.
しかし、一つのブローチは一人の願いしか叶えない。家具の僕たちはこの一つのブローチによってどちらかしか結ばれ得ないのです。
Is the single live coal of love that the old, shrilly laughing Beatrice had sown. That Beatrice had likened humans who were tormented by this coal to ripe fruit and had enjoyed it evilly. However, the magic infused within this seed was real. It was the only crystallization of magic that the Golden Witch of Beatrice ever left in this world. Its glint increased.
大丈夫です。でも、直接は見ないで。目をやられます。
What? The glint grew even stronger, shining like the sun. Jessica didn't need Cannon to tell her to put her hands over her eyes. As the light grew stronger, a sound like the roar of the wind or tide also grew in intensity. The sound of the wind and rain outside had already been overwhelmed. Jessica could no longer even stand, and she crouched on the floor. A flood of sound and light, until it withdrew, Jessica could do nothing but moan. Shannon standing there afterwards. Or just not. Just cut to somewhere else. Okay, sure, game. Or are we going back to that creepy room? Aw. Thank God. Really don't like it in there.
Sa sa sa. Ima wa daijoubu desu yo. Isogimashou.
お父様が甘いものをお好きだといいのですが。
ええ、お好きですもの。甘いものに限らず、何でもよくお召し上がりになりますよ。
After waiting for the master of the study to be out, Beato and Kumasawa entered the study. They quickly cleaned up the books on the desk and sat down in the basket they had brought there and opened it up.Inside were several cute cookies cut out in a butterfly shape. Oh, fucking course they are. They set out a cute plate and neatly decorated it with the cookies. It was the kind of slight adornment that the person eating wasn't likely to even notice. The whole setup was filled with that same sort of feeling.
今の私に許されていることはこんなことくらいですので。
わらわがバトラにクッキーをか。なぜに夜の支配者であるわらわが稀な客人であるバトラにそこまで尽くすのかわからぬ。
Then the study door swung violently open. It was Battler with Genji by his side. Oh, hey, Kenzo, how's it going?Beller's eyes went wide for a second when he saw Beato there, but his expression quickly went blank again.
ここで何をしている？
お父様、失礼しました。決して大切なゲームの邪魔に来たわけでは。
どうしてここに入れた？ここには鍵がかかっていたはず。
申し訳ございません。親方様に内密で差し入れをお届けしたいとのことで、私が…
ほら見てあげてくださいませ。親方様に喜んでもらおうと、ベアトリーチェ様が一生懸命クッキーを焼いたんですよ。
I'd eat them.
熊沢さんと源氏さんに習いました。源氏さんがクッキーを焼くのがお上手だったなんて、とても驚きました。
最近は全然ですけど、昔の源氏さんは、それはもういろいろなお料理を作ってくれたんですよ。特にお菓子作りはお上手で。
クッキ
ー？はい、お父様への差し入れです。大切なゲームの必勝を心よりお祈りいたしております。
Bella looked up at the plate on the study desk that was piled with beautiful cookies and the message card of encouragement lying next to it. And its face twisted with a complex expression, which might have had traces of both sadness and anger contained within it.
Oyakata-sama.
Genji urged him to consider saying some words of gratitude to Beato. Balor understood. He had no reason to respond to this kindness with displeasure. Even though he understood it logically, he couldn't help but give a small exaggerated sigh.
Arigato. Kansha suru. だが甘いものは苦手だ。下げてくれ。
お、親方様。
同じことをもう一度言わせるな。片付けて下がってくれ。
デック
。お、親方様、せめて一口。
Look, I mean, even if you don't like her, at least have her cookies. She put her heart and soul into it. Don't crotch them. Don't be a dick.
Beatrice 様が親方様のためを思いこしらえたものでございます。
気持ちはありがたく受け取っておく。
Are you though?
今は大切なゲームの最中だ。俺にとってもベアトにとっても大切な最後のゲームなんだ。だから頼む。俺の心をかき乱すような真似は慎んでくれ。
But they're to make you feel better.
それはあまりにもひどうございます。気持ちは感謝する。大いに結構でございます。しかし、それをせめて一口お召しになる形ではお示しできませんか？
I agree.
お父様。
Don't make her cry, dick. Beato looked at Balor sadly. Balor hung his head to avoid her gaze.The expression on his face caused Beato more pain than any he had shown her before.
Kumasawa,
you're
a douche. Sagaru yoni.
Oyakata-sama.
Kumasawa clung to Battler, but he turned his back to her.
Shitsure shimashita. Katasuke masho, Kumasawa-san.
Soyu wake ni wa mairimasen.
I will not stand for this.
大切なゲームに少しでも力添えしたいベアトリーチェ様がせめてこのような形でもお力になりたいと、それを一口さえせずに下げろとは、女をバカにするにも程がございます。
I agree.
熊沢。
Fuck off, Genji.
親方様も男ならば、女の手作りの差し入れにせめてどうか一口で結構でございますので、
True.
お手をつけてくださいまし。女の気持ちを踏みにじろうというおつもりでしたら、殺されたってここは引きませんよ。ええ、引きません。
熊沢さん、もう結構ですから。
そういうわけには参りません。親方様、これに毒でも入っているとお思いですか？
Just eat the damn cookie. Yeah. If Beato ever came to give me cookies, of course I'd think that she'd put some kind of crazy poison in them. She asked me if I thought there'd be poison in these. Do you really think that cookies piled up in such a neat and cute way could possibly have something bizarre hidden inside. Nah, there's no needles in there. And who could possibly imagine that Beato, who would ever make something like that, she said. Because of that, Battler couldn't bear to look at Beato's innocent reaction. Fucking eat it! Which was completely free from any malicious thoughts of slipping poison into the cookies. Just eat the damn cookie. It's not hard. Beato quietly started to clean up. Every now and then she sniffled. You fucking dick! Kumasawa continued to glare at Battler. But she then gave a small sigh and helped Beato clean up. However, the hardness didn't disappear from her expression. Look, I don't care if you're still upset that, you know, your Beatrice isn't back or not. Doesn't mean you can't eat some fucking cookies that she made. Just eat the damn cookie. You're not in the position to be making requests right now. Why don't you just tell her to wear a different outfit? So she could be a different girl. I don't know. That's easier. Hanging her head so low that her chin touched her chest, Beato hurried out of the study. After giving Battler a look, Kumasawa chased after her. You're a douche. Kumasawa threw the door open a bit violently, and then footsteps of the pair rapidly disappeared off into the distance. Your brother's a dick. No, that's terrible. I don't give a fuck if it's Beato or not. You could just... Come on. Come on. Look, I know he's upset that she's not the same that she used to be. It doesn't give you an excuse to be, you know, an absolute prick to her. It just doesn't. You can be upset about it, sure. You can be really, you know, lonely, all the above, everything associated with it. It doesn't give you free rein to act that way, though. Just because she's different or acts differently than how he remembers doesn't mean he should act that way to her. I don't like it as just a human. I think it's just a dick thing to do. No, I understand where he's coming from. I know where he's coming from. It doesn't excuse it, though. I don't think it excuses it. I know where he's coming from. I do. But I don't think it gives him free rein to act however he wants to. I still don't understand what kind of antagonism or connection there was between them. However, Oni-chan probably views Beato as a friendly rival, if not something more. Oni-chan's reason for defeating Beato isn't to destroy an enemy out of hatred. It feels like he wants to give her a sincere answer to her questions. Yes, I can't deny the fact that their fight isn't based on hatred but on a stronger emotion. Love.
どうして、お兄ちゃんにあそこまで尽くすのか理解できないわ。そしてその理解できる要素は紛れもなく我々の知る黄金の魔女ベアトリーチェに受け継がれるものである。ええ、理解しているわ。このベアトを知ることもまた、やがてのベアトを知ることにつながる。そしてそれは、このおかしなゲームで最大の大駒と、あるいは、このゲーム版そのものを説明するかもしれない。
Though she said those words, Feathering wore a confident smile on her face. Her sarcastic confidence, as though she already knew the answer, was unchanged.
Beatrice, 話を聞きたいわ。
はい。何でしょうか、エンジェさん。
When Angie asked her question, Beato, who had been reading a fragment of a book in the shadows of the study, jumped.
あなたは、なんで後ろ宮バトラをお父様と呼ぶの？
Battler's his own fucking dad. Is this where it's gonna go now?
私という駒を生み出してくださったからです。
Oh, okay.
では、どうして後ろ宮バトラにそこまで尽くすの？駒は生み出した造物種に絶対服従しなくてはならないルールでもあるの？
そんなルールはない。
Yeah, I was gonna say I don't think there was because Angie broke the rule that the only rule she had.
駒は道具、あるいはナイフだ。ゲームマスターが上手に扱えば便利な道具になる。
しかし扱いを間違えれば自らを傷つけもする。道具になろうと狂気になろうとそこに道具の意思はない。ただ結果があるだけだ。
じゃあどうしてあんたはお兄ちゃんにアームを尽くすの？まるでそれはあなたという駒の目的かのようだわ。
あ、はい、それが私が生み出された目的だからです。
あんたを生み出したお兄ちゃん自身がその目的を与えたの？
それは違う。バトラはゲームマスターとしてそういう役目を持った駒を盤上に置いたに過ぎない。そして彼女という駒を生み出したのはこのゲームを生み出した最初のゲームマスターであるベアトリーチェ自身だ。
はあ、ややこしい話だわ。つまりあんたはお兄ちゃんのことをお父様お父様呼んでるけど別に父親ってわけじゃないのね。
I didn't think so.
あんたはお兄ちゃんに尽くさなければならないという目的のために。
It's a very interesting way to show affection, but sure.
親しみを込めてお父様と呼んでるだけだわ。
あ、はい、そうだと思います。私という駒を盤上に置いてくださったのがお父様です。お父様が盤上に置かなければ私という駒の出番はありません。ですから私がここにこうして存在し、そして私の目的のために尽くせるのは全てお父様のおかげなのです。
なるほど。そしてそれはお父様と呼ぶのにふさわしいってわけね。じゃあ誰があんたにお兄ちゃんに尽くすように命じたの？ああ、それは初代ゲームマスターのベアト自身よね。ああ、ややこしい。
なぜにそなたは後ろ宮バトラに尽くさねばならぬのかと尋ねたいのであろう。しかしそれを彼女に答えることはできぬ。
That's like asking a knife, why do you cut things? That's just because what I do.
彼女に与えられたのは目的だけだ。その目的を与えた動機は与えた本人にしかわからぬのだから。
なるほど、それも考えてみるがいい人の子よってわけね。で、ついでにあんたにはもうその察しがついていて、ニヤニヤしながら私が悩んでいるのを見ているってわけだわ。
そなたは我が巫女としてつくづく優秀だ。
I'm gonna have to really think on that one.
私はお父様に尽くします。
Maybe it's her true feelings as a Beatrice? That, you know, if nothing went wrong, nothing of those 7 years had happened, and everything was perfect, this is what she views herself, what she'd be like.
私の存在がお父様の幸福のお役に立てる。
So, i.e. her, you know, her love for Battler just put into one piece. So it could be her true feelings as well, or her feelings before Battler left or whatever for the 7 years beforehand. At that point, Beato hesitated.
Nani? So して何を?
Ah, hi. So してそれをいつかお父様にお認めいただければ、それが私の一番の幸せなのです。
何をそれ、尽くしたいってだけなら、まさに魔女の家具ねと言いたいところだけど、それを認めてもらいたい？それじゃ家具ってより。
Angie stopped mid-sentence. That's less like furniture and more like you're just a girl who loves Oni-chan. I don't get it. The guiding force behind this Beato's actions is that of a girl who adores Oni-chan. But then what does that make this Beato? If the first Beato liked Oni-chan, then she should have adored him and done things for him herself. Why would she create a piece of herself, a separate entity, to do it? I want to say it's to show how much she changed by him not being around, or him committing a sin and being gone quote-unquote 1,000 years. I think that's maybe what it's trying to show, like just the complete difference of what 7 years did to her. To show, hey, this is what I was like now, or then, now this is what I am now because of you. Maybe that's why.